went to a posh all-boys school. Lots of people that go to posh all-boys schools don't do any housework. They have a cleaner. Ben looks like he gets his cleaner for an extra 20 quid to do his balls as well. 25 if she live streams it to her cousin in Poland. £38.50 if she live streams it to her kids.
Listen, you've got to diversify your income streams nowadays. So, Cressida is precariously employed and lives on a canal boat. And her canal boat is just like her. It's high maintenance, unstable in bad weather, and requires frequent pumping to stop getting too damp.
All right. This is Ben. Ben went to a posh all-boys school. And lots of people that go to posh all-boys schools spend the rest of their adulthood trying to forget the creepy teachers who molested them. Ben has decided to face it head on. You know, he faces his past head on, and every single day he confronts that teacher in the mirror.
I wasn't even molested as a child, so it wasn't very hard then. I've grown into my looks, is what I'm saying. Cressida's parents divorced when she was young. Now, Cress, I hope that they told you that the divorce wasn't because of anything you did. It was just because of a general vibe. Just like a bad energy. Apparently her dad was like, is there somewhere I could see her only on weekends?
You look like Saddam Hussein was brought back to life and decided to try and rebrand as a male feminist.
Is that it? Okay. Thanks, Chancellor Merkel. Cressida was born with diabetes and she's pushing 40, so she has to live a healthy lifestyle nowadays. She used to be into baking, but she had to give that up. Not because of the sugar, it's just that it made her sad when she realised that some of the cakes she was making had more eggs inside them than she does. Thank you, Liz Truss's dark future. Cressida's been doing stand-up for 8 years, and she told me she has nothing to show for it. Which I think is, you're being harsh on yourself there, because she was the Funny Women New Act Competition 2018 regional finalist. Okay. But comedy aside, you've achieved something, because you have type 1 diabetes, and you're 38, so you've already lived longer than God wanted you to.
Right. Ben is part of the furry community. Which is brilliant. If you don't know, that's the people who are into anthropomorphized animals. And so he performs stand-up as a dog. A dog called Rover. It's not clear what breed Rover is, but he's like the dog you'd get if an abused bulldog had a one-night stand with Eugene Levy or something. Like, his stand-up, and like the dog, it reminds me of the dog from Marley and Me because it dies. I love dogs, man. I used to have a dog called Mabel. She was amazing, but towards the end of her life, like, she was deaf and blind and incontinent, and we had to have her put down. So we went to the vets, and me and my family, like, we watched this dog who we'd loved for 14 years die in front of us. And it was a lot better than watching Ben set.
I just want to make it clear that I do stand up as a dog. There's nothing sexual about it. I mean, you know, it's me in the costumes. Obviously, it's quite sexual for a lot of people. So Cressida is anti-feminist and a fan of Jordan Peterson. That's true, right?
That's what you mean by feminist, guys. Which way? Fourth is bollocks, right?
Yeah. Jordan Peterson fan, can't give a straight answer. Cress believes that trans women shouldn't be allowed to take part in women's comedy contests because they have an obvious biological advantage. If you're mad about that one, remember that's what she thinks. I think that all women are funny.
Yeah.